Well, it is back to school for so many students today, including college students, more than 50,000 of them going back to school at San Diego City, Miramar, and Mesa Colleges.
Ed Lenderman is live at Mesa College in Claremont with more. Good morning, Ed.
Hi, Ed.
Hey, good morning, guys. Good morning, everybody. Yeah, 53,000 to be specific. We are here at Mesa College, which has the largest student population, over 20,000. Yes, back to and the start of school. And when we visited with you at 6 o'clock, we were talking to longtime Mesa College president Pamela Luster about a number of things. Good morning.
Good morning, Ed.
Nice to see you.
Great to see you as well.
Exciting day.
It's the best.
Yeah.
Absolutely the best, other than commencement.
Okay.
First days of the semester are awesome.
I started to say when we left her, and we did talk about the Promise Program and some new other things that are going on here, but we ended with the fact, and we want to explore that a little bit. This college is offering a year degree program. It is the only one, and that's all part of a state mandate in the college district. And you've now graduated that class. It's health information management, and you've had two graduations in that particular degree program.
That is correct, and we have a brand new group of students starting today.
So tell us about how the four-year degree program came about and the fact that you want to expand that, meaning the district and the state.
You bet. Well, we know we need many, many thousand bachelor's degree holders and that all of our systems are pretty clogged with all the students that are already here. So we looked at programs that are workforce development related, not ones you get at CSUs or UCs, to fill jobs. And so that's why we came up with health information management at Mesa College.
Okay. You are not to compete with
correct
the so-called four-year schools, SDSU, UCS, that's part of the mandate, and who decides that?
Well, the state legislature decides okay. That. It came about through legislation.
But certainly Miramar and City College, they're all back to school. They would like to have a four-year degree program, too.
Absolutely. They have many programs that they would be excited about expanding and launching in the bachelor's degree area.
And that's going to take the state to do that?
It will. We're going to be advocating again this year for expanding. We're doing some research, working with the legislative analyst's office to show that what we're doing is working. Always good to go with your strengths. So we know students are getting employed, doing very well. Students are leaving Mesa College making $80,000, $90,000 a year right out the door with no student loan debt.
Oh, no, yes. Let's talk about the cost as opposed to a four-year school such as UCSD, which is a little expensive every year.
Well, we love our partner San Diego State and UCSD, but when it comes to these programs, it's $46 a unit with an $84 per unit additive at the bachelor's degree level. A little over $10,000 soup to nuts.
Okay. Well, if I'm looking at what's going on with the student loan debt, which is a crisis, now, I can't imagine that the community colleges aren't overwhelmed, hence we need to start offering four-year degrees. Does that make sense?
Absolutely, especially those that put students right in jobs. And that's the whole idea, is to really build the local economy and build middle-class jobs for our families.
So where do we stand in 2019 with the legislature and or the educational people?
So we will be working again with our local legislators, the ones that helped us out the last time, getting that data forward to show that all 15 of the programs statewide are doing very, very well, and then look for expansion beyond that.
All right. Speaking of, and if you're just joining us, we do want to get into the Promise Program. It's been a huge success.
Big success.
And please explain what it is.
Absolutely. So Promise Program, first-time, full-time freshmen can come in, and we don't really use the term freshmen, but first-time students come in, and they have tuition waived, including book vouchers and other kinds of assistance to stay in school.
Okay. And what is their obligation?
Their obligation is to stay as a full-time student. They take a course in how to go to college, and I simplified that. It's really called personal growth, keeping you in college, time management, all those kinds of things, and then just being a wonderful service provider to our community. They can do some service hours as well.
Okay. In another half an hour, we're going to be talking with Ms. Luster as well as some students here, and then you're off in a golf cart. This is, you travel the campus today.
I do indeed. It's a big place, and we like to make sure students feel welcome, and so why not see the college president the first day you're here and get a little help, maybe a map, a water bottle, and just some friendly advice.
You have some goodies in the cart?
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Water and granola and
anything
bars?
It takes to get them to not be anxious.
So what's the biggest, you mentioned to me, and we'll deal with this at 7 o'clock, parking?
Yeah, parking can be a challenge. We tell students, especially first 2 weeks, students are trying to add classes.
Yeah.
So we have even more students on campus than would normally be here just taking classes. So we suggest the bus, have someone drop you off, Lyft, whatever your favorite provider might be, just get here as you can. But parking's gone about 9.
Okay, yeah, in a lot of places. Longtime president of Mesa College, Pamela Lester, we'll see you at 7.
Thank you, Ed.
All right, thank you. All right, we are 53,000 strong today, our local community college district, 20,000 plus here at Mesa College. Back to you guys. Start of school or back to school?
Yeah, it's here. Summer vacation, goodbye, right? Thank you, Ed.
Yeah, goodbye.